Step by step. Level 4. Lesson number 2. Pencil shading. Use 6D pencil to shade the given object. Do you know generally why do we shade the objects? It's just a simple thing. Shading is used to give a 3D look to any object. It can be a pencil shade or it can be a color shade. So here one object is given, a cuboid, showing the light source from at the corner, right top corner, and the shadow is opposite side. Example is given here, a cuboid with a baseline. Above the baseline we call this part as background, and below the baseline we call it as foreground. Light is placed here. The light source may reach this part here to this one as well as this part. But this face is completely opposite to the light. Let's see an example. I have an object here, a cube. I want to show you the demonstration by using a cube. How the light reaches the particular faces on the cube or a cuboid. If I tilt this one, my light source is from behind. This part is bright. This one is a bit dark. Observe the difference between these two shapes. It's a bright and it's a darker one. So same, if I show you more faces, I'm just tilting this one. See here, light is reaching this face as well as this face, but not this one. This opposite to the light. So it is dark. If I tilt this side, we can see the slight difference here. This face is completely bright and then this is opposite to the light. So it is dark. And I tilt more like this. See this one. Now these two faces are bright, but this one is a darker one. If I turn it towards the light source, now it became the bright one. These two faces became dark. So we have to observe how the light source is reaching on the object and how the shades are forming. That's right, whether it's a bright, light or dark, everything need to be observed to do well with our drawing life. Let's go on with shading. Use a 6D pencil to shade the given object. I have different drawing pencils here, different grades of pencils. Let's take a 6D. I'm taking a 6D pencil. Keep your pencil in underpalm position, like how you hold a knife, not like in pen position. It's called pen position. When you hold that pencil like this, it's called underpalm position. Hold a pencil like this and start shading at this part. Light is reaching this face as well as this one, but not this one. So let us shade it into a darker one. Keep your pencil as less slanted as possible to the surface of the sheet and start moving your pencil to form a shade. It's called underpalm position. Carefully shade near the lines here, I mean at this line, or even you cross these lines, you can erase it afterwards. You cannot worry about this one, this part. Carefully shade at the top edge. Give the same kind of pressure to get same kind of shade. If you leave your pressure, it becomes light like this. I'm leaving my pressure, so it became light, but we want it same shade. Let's see about the shadow part here, how to shade, where the shadow forms actually. So here I have the same example. I'm keeping here, my light source is from behind, I mean towards this side. Shadow formed here. See, if I turn this one particularly, now shadow is here from both the sides. So I have like plenty of lighting here, so the shadow is very short here. In the same way, the light source is from this way. the shadow will be in the opposite direction. That means here. Let us shade this one. I'm holding my pencil in the same way under palm position, resting my finger to give support. If you have any pencil lines out of these borders, you can take a razor and edit those parts. That's it from lesson number 2. Let's sign off.